Hey guys, welcome back to another video in Code 4. In this video, we are going to look at Chapter 3 in IGCSE Computer Science Cambridge endorsed book, and that's Logic Gates and Logic Circuit. This chapter is so easy and interesting if you listen this video fully. So make sure you watch this video fully, and there is also a question to help you understand. So make sure you see that. Before we start, in case you haven't subscribed Code 4, make sure you subscribe. In this chapter, there are three main subtopics. They are logic gates, truth table, and logic circuit. So now let's get started. First, let's see logic gates. But before that, we need to know what are logic gates. Logic gates take binary inputs and produce a binary output. Several logic gates combine together to form a logic circuit, and these circuits are designed to carry out a specific function. The checking of the output from a logic gate or a logic circuit is done using a truth table. In case you haven't watched the first chapter explanatory video, click the card right on your screen. There are six logic gates which we will discuss clearly in the next few minutes. In a nutshell, these are the logic gates and their symbols. They are NOT gate, AND gate, OR gate, NAND gate, NOR gate, XOR. Now let's see what is a truth table in detail. It is used to trace the output from a logic or logic circuit. When constructing truth table, all possible combinations of ones and zeros which can be input are considered. Ones and zeros because binary are only considered. The number of combinations are 2 to the power n, where n is the number of variables. 2 is written here because in binary there are only 2 digits and they are 0 and 1 respectively. So now let's move to the first logic gate. The first logic gate which we are going to look at is AND gate. It performs logical multiplication. In Boolean algebra, it is denoted by the symbol dot. It requires two inputs and there is only one output. So the symbol of AND gate is here. And the truth table for this is this. Here, when writing the truth table, you have to write the number of variables first. So here there are two inputs, that is A and B. So the number of variables are A and B, which is 2. So first you need to write 2 to the power n. 2 to the power 2 is equal to 4. So there are 4 combinations. You can write 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. These are the possible combinations which you can do using two variables. Now you have to solve it in an AND gate. So AND gate is like multiplication. The output is only 1 if both inputs are 1. Here 1 means true and 0 means false. So here at first 0, 0 is 0 because there is no double 1. Here 0, 1. Think it like normal math. 0 into 1 is 0 and 1 into 0 is also 0. At last there is 1 into 1 which is 1. This is so simple and I hope you understand AND gate. The next gate is OR gate. It performs logical addition. In Boolean algebra, it is denoted by the symbol plus. It requires two inputs and produces one input. So the same input is considered. Since 2 to the power 2 is 4 and all these four combinations are considered, but the output is different. You have to use the plus symbol. So here 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. 1 plus 1 is equal to 1. You may ask, why is 1 plus 1 is equal to 1? Is it 2? But here in binary addition, if we do 1 plus 1, the carryover is 1. So the output will also be 1. I hope you understand OR gate. The next logic gate is NOT gate. It is denoted by the symbol A dash. It needs only one input. Out of all the six logic gates which I mentioned earlier, this is the only gate which needs only one input. All others require minimum of two inputs. Here, the symbol of NOT gate is denoted like this, a triangle with a circle at its edge. Now here, since there are only one input, the n value is 1. So 2 to the power 1 is 2. So there are only two possible combinations, that is 0 and 1. Here, the output is 1 if the input is 0 and the output is 0 if the input is 1. It is just the opposite. I hope you understand NOT gate. Now let's move on to the next gate. The next logic gate is NOR gate. It is also called NOT OR gate. It is denoted by A plus B whole dash. The symbol for NOT gate is this. The value of inputs are 00, 01, 10, and 11. We discussed earlier that for OR gate, the value of output is 1 if any of the values of input are 1. But in NOR gate, it is different. The value of output is 1 if and only if the two inputs are 0. So here, the input are 0 and 0, the output is 1. The next line, 0 and 1, here there is a 1. So the output is 0. Same for the next one, 1, 0. A 1 is already there in A variable, so the output is 0. And A plus B, that is 1 plus 1 whole dash, so it is 0. Since there is already a 1 placed in both variables. In case you find this hard, you can also do in this way. You can write the value of A plus B first. That is, the value of A plus B is nothing but OR gate. It will be 0, 1, 1, 1. Now, make it into a NOT gate. So, 0, 1, 1, 1 will pass through a NOT gate and will become 1, 0, 0, 0. Because as I told you earlier, 1 will become zeros and zeros will become 1. I hope you understand this method. Now let's move on to the next logic gate. The next logic gate is NAND gate. It is also called NOT AND gate. It is denoted by the symbol A dot B whole dash. The symbol for NAND gate looks like this in the image below. The truth table for NAND gate is like this. Since there are only two inputs, the value of inputs are always the same. 00, 01, 10, and 11. Now here, the output is 1 if there is a 0 in an input. If both inputs are 1, the value of output is 0. So here, 0 into 0 whole dash will become 1. Then here, 0 and 1 is there in the second row. So here there is a 0, so the output will become 1. The next row, 1, 0. There is a 0 here, so the output will become 1. The last row, 1, 1. There is no 0 here, so it will become 0. Another method is, first do A dot B. That is nothing but AND gate. It will become 0, 0, 0, 1. Now process it into an NOT gate. All zeros will get converted into ones. So it will become 1, 1, 1, 0. I hope you understand NAND gate. Now let's move on to the next gate. The next logic gate is XOR gate. It is a special gate. The output X is 1 if input A is 1 and input B is 0. Or input A is 0 and input B is 1. The symbol for XOR gate is this. You can also remember the truth table like this way. The value of output is 1 if the both values of input are different. The value of output is 0 if the both value of input are similar. So here, 0, 0. The value of X will be 0 since both values are similar. The next value is 0, 1. It will be 1 because both are different. And the same way for the next row, 1, 0. Both are different, so it will be 1. The last row is 1, 1. Both are similar, so the value of output is 0. Now let's have a quick recap. For NOT gate, the logic notation is NOT A. In Boolean algebra, it is A dash. For AND gate, the logic notation is A AND B. In Boolean algebra, it is A dot B. For OR gate, the logic notation is A OR B. In Boolean algebra, it is A plus B. For NAND gate, the logical notation is A NAND B. In Boolean algebra, it is A dot B whole dash. For NOR gate, the logic notation is A NOR B. And Boolean algebra is A plus B whole dash. And for XOR gate, the logic notation is A XOR B. And the Boolean algebra is a dot b dash plus a dash dot b. This is also written as a plus b dot a dot b whole dash. If you are still watching this video, this is the best practice question I can give you. The question is, draw the logical circuit and write the truth table for this Boolean algebra. The Boolean algebra is a dot b dash plus b dot c dash. The logical circuit will be like this. So here there are three variables. So write a, b, c with some space. Now the question was a dot b dash. First you have to complete the things in the bracket. Then do the things which is not in the bracket. So first a dot b dash. Dot means AND gate and dash means NOT gate. B dash. So attach a NOT symbol to B first. Then attach a AND symbol to A and B NOT. It will be like this. This is the part 1 of the logical circuit. The part 2 is the second bracket. B dot C dash. First attach a NOT gate to C. Then take a line from B and attach it with AND gate to the output of C naught as the input of AND gate. This is part 3. But part 2 is the plus symbol. This is also called as OR gate. So you have to attach part 1 and part 3 using a OR gate symbol and draw a line from the output and label it X. This is how you draw the logical circuit for this Boolean algebra. Now let's see how to write the truth table for this logic circuit. There are three inputs, namely A, B, C. So the number of possible combinations are 2 to the power 3, which is 8. So follow me. For A, it will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. And for B, it will be 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. And for C, it will be 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So in the question, we saw B naught, C naught, A and B naught, B and C naught. So first, write the value for B naught. So B naught, all zeros get converted to 1, all 1 get converted to 0. Here, the value of B is written and the value of B naught is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. Likewise, do the same for C naught. So the value of C is 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So the value of C naught is 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. After writing the values of B naught and C naught, we have to do A and B naught. So first write the value of A and the value of B naught. The value of B naught is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. The value of A is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. Now, this is getting processed in an AND gate. So, the output will be 1 if and only if both the inputs are 1. So, here 1, 0, the output is 0. 1, 0, the output is 0. 0, 0, the output is 0. 0, 0, the output is 0. 1, 1, the output is 1. 1, 1, the output is 1. 0, 1, the output is 0. 0, 1, the output is 0. This is step 2. Now let's move on to the step 3. So the next step is writing the truth table for B and C naught. So the value of B is 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. The value of C naught is 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. We have discussed this earlier on how to do. So now we have to process this into an AND gate. So 0, 1, the output is 0. 0, 0, the output is 0. 1, 1, both values are 1, so the output is 1. 1, 0, the value is 0. 0, 1, the output is 0. 0, 0, the output is 0. 1, 1, the output is 1. And 1, 0, the output is 0. Now, the last step is using an OR gate. So, we found the value of A and B naught and B and C naught. Now, we have to process this output as the input for OR gate. So OR gate output will be 1 if any of the inputs are 1. So here 0, 0, no inputs are 1, so the output is 0. Likewise, 00, 0, 0, 1 is 1 because there is a 1 in variable b. 00, 0, 1, 0 is 1, 1, 0 is 1, 0, 1 is 1, and 0, 0 is 0. So the final output is 00, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. I hope you understand this question. That's the end of video. Thanks for watching and make sure you subscribe Code 4. If you want more videos, comment below on which video you need.